Drew Tube. Welcome to Hashtag Religion Week TV. I'm your host, Drew L. Murray, and here we sip a lot of tea with no shade, talking everything up the Yahweh. Enjoy the video. Tea no shade.
It wasn't wimps, and if they were wimps like Ezekiel, he ran and hit his face several times. I run and hide my face. Jeremiah, he cried all the time, like you see me crying. I don't care about shedding no tear when it comes to the word of God, because it's passion. And if you're not passionate over your life, over your soul, who the hell gonna be passionate over it? So I tear up that way. You don't know how a person responds, but you can't be weak. You can't be timid. You can't go and say, oh, God says, you know, you living wrong, that the word is different. You can't do that. Hold on, Salafa. They went out again. YouTube, I just bear with me. Hang in there. It's not going to be much longer. Oh, man, I can't wait to get my cake. I can't wait to get some strong internet up in here. We going to have some great talks and great teachings going on. Oh, thank you so much. I was just telling the others, I got somebody on my Nook, and I got, hey, Mike, how you doing? I got Mike and Lola over here. Thank you, guys. I'm going to get some real internet up in here. Oh, no. I got to plug you up. Hold on. I'm going to get some real internet up in here, and we're going to be able to have some decent talks. And, you know, just I'm going to stick to my truth, what I know God is asking me to do. Okay, hang in there. Hold on. This thing says going out. I don't want to lose you guys. All right. There we go. Okay. All right. So, listen. What I was saying is, you can't die two different ways. You can't die righteous, unrighteous, okay? I'm going to get right into it. People think when I post on Facebook, I'm proud. I think I got it all together in God, and I be the first one. God, I don't want to say that to those people. I don't want to be the one to bring this to those people. And I sit in here all day long before I even come to make the post or say what I got to say. Like, with real humility and humbleness, because I don't want to be in confrontation with other people. That's just me. But if you're going to speak for God, you don't care who you get in confrontation with. And really, the confrontation is with the prince of powers that be, not with that person. I was saying when you went off, when I post, people think I'm proud and I have a proud look. I don't want to say half the stuff I say, but when you sit back and see people post and say what they say, you gotta be the one to say, whoa, 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 wait a minute, dear Lord. Somebody gotta interject and put something out there that make you think, like, wait a minute. If not, everybody will be posting that same nonsense out there. So, a proud look. I don't have a proud look. I say every day, God, I can't do even get on here and talk to y'all publicly if he don't give me the strength. I'd rather shut it all down and just sit here, read my Bible, and say, one day, God, somebody will hear me. Or hear you through me. You know what I'm saying? All right, so we're going to just read these. When they come back on, Salafa, I appreciate it. We're just going to read what the other six things are and go from there. Oh, come on, Facebook, come on, come on, come on. YouTube, thank you so much. All right, come on, Facebook, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Thank you so much for coming back. All right, I'm just going to read through the other six things so you can hear. That way, if you have to go, I understand. But then I'll go back through and talk them down. So, a proud look. I always thought this was me, but it's not really me. I don't have a proud look when I come do what I do. I couldn't say half this stuff or even come up with it on my own if it wasn't for God showing me where it's at in the Bible and explaining to me what it means. See, a lot of you know where it's at, know what it say, but do you understand what it means? Proud means a person who just believe in their own self-interest and their own self-worth and their own self-possessions. That's not me, because I care about your soul. If that was me, I'd be like, oh, I did a good teaching today. I preached them down. You know how you hear some people, I. Well, that's what the devil did in the book of Isaiah, was all about, I will. That's what pride is. You don't hear me talk like that. Well, thank you, Salafa. You came back. All right, hang in there 1 second. So, you will never hear me talk prideful like that and say, oh, I came up with a good post. I came up with a good sermon. Half the time, you don't even hear me say, I cooked a good meal. I'd be like, if it wasn't for the grace of God, if it wasn't but for the grace of God. And that's how I talk, because I know the devil say he did everything. Devil be, I. That's pride. God don't like pride. That's why he says 7 things he hates is a proud look. Now, I'm not a proud. Now, we're not talking about looks where, oh, you looking. Yeah, you're supposed to look decent and have a decent look about you or whatever. We're talking about that prideness where you don't say, oh God, if it wasn't for you, this would have never happened. You understand what I'm saying? If you out there talking about, oh, look at the car I got, look at the house I got, look at the shoes I got, and ain't giving God no credit, and you call yourself a Christian, he hates you. He hates you. He hates you. Hold on, Salah, for 1 second. Hold on 1 second. This is in your Bible, guys. This ain't me sitting here telling you this. This is what I noticed in the world, and I asked God to show me some insight on what's going on around the world so that I could put his input into it. Okay, so I appreciate that. But no, this is Christians doing that. He says he hate a proud look, a person who says, don't give him no credit for nothing. Oh, I got my job, I got my house, I got my car, I. Sit down with your proud ass, because he hates you. And you could change that around, just say, Lord, I repent for being prideful. I don't have nothing. I got a song I wrote that says, there's nothing I own that belongs to me. God gave me a loan on all that you see. He blesses me to be a steward for thee. Now he's blessing me as I have blessed he, okay? That's it. You don't nothing in this world you own. If it wasn't for God, you wouldn't have half the stuff you have. But a lot of y'all out there with the proud look talking about, look what I did. God don't like that. He actually hates it. He actually hates it, okay? So that's something we can do to change. Now, this ain't got nothing to do with your drinking, your smoking, or none of that. This is about being prideful. This is about being prideful. Hold on, Salah, for 1 second. God bless you so much. Come on, Facebook. I'm waiting on this side to come in. It would be nice if they all went on your instrument over on the nook where you are, Salah, for I could turn this phone off. Thank you so much. But no, that's a proud look. Let's go on. Okay, a lying tongue is second. Anybody that know me know I don't have no reason to lie to you, because Bible says God, the devil, is the no. All right, no, don't power off. No. Oh my God, no. Oh, shoot. Come on, Salafa. Oh! Oh, my God. Come on back in here. Hold on, YouTube. Thank you, Salafa. Actually, the other phone went off, and I left the floor. If there's any way they can come on this unit right here, I would appreciate it. I'm still on Facebook Live, y'all. I'm on another channel, I guess, another nook. But a lying tongue. Oh, I can't get this phone back on. A lying tongue is something God hates. Because he said the devil is the father of lies. So why are we out here lying to one another? No, 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 no. If we out here lying to one another, then God clearly says that the devil is our father according to the word. Who wants the devil to be their father? Not me. So you won't catch me out here lying about nothing I do in my personal life or nothing I do for the word of God. Because the Bible says do it all unto the glory of the Lord if that's what you're going to do. I'm not here to judge you. I'm here to show you what God hates. I'm here to show you what God hates. There's six things that's an abomination. Oh, come on, Facebook. Come over there, please. Oh, this phone went dead. I apologize, guys. After today, I'm going to make sure everything is charged up. Everything is working properly. I didn't really know. Usually, I'm talking to myself. God doesn't send me many people. Oh, what happened? All right, YouTube, hang in there. Just hang in there with me, please. I'm going to get through a talk without crying one day, but if you ain't passionate about nothing, not that tears have to bring passion, but for me, when it comes about talking about the Word of God, passion brings tears because I'm excited about this stuff. It does something to my spirit. I don't know if it does anything to your spirit, but talking about the Word of God, being shown true, being able to say, okay, how do I separate myself from the confused ones, from the hateful ones? Because Christians are blended in all together. You do that by following the Word of God, finding out what God loves, what he don't love, what he hates, what he do hate. You know, you find out what God wants. I'm going to try to pick this up over here again. Let's say power off. And then that one is done. Okay. So, a lying tongue is the second one. We're going to keep moving, Salafa. I appreciate it. So then the third one is hands that shed innocent blood. It happens. People walk into church and shed innocent blood. I don't have that on my hands. I pray you don't have that on your hands. But here's another definition of shedding innocent blood. It's keeping people from knowing the truth. Keeping people from knowing Christ. Keeping people not sharing your testimony. Not sharing your witness. Not sharing your experience with God with other people will actually shed innocent blood. I do apologize. We're almost done here. YouTube, I'm going to just wait one more second for Facebook to come back up and then we can go on and finish. Alright, thank you, Salafa. So, that innocent shedding of blood, we may not take a physical gun and go kill nobody or stab nobody and shed their blood that way, but we criticize them, we shame them, we hurt them, and that's shedding innocent blood, people. You may not see you doing it, but that's what you're doing. Even when somebody is trying to shed light on somebody and open somebody's eyes and their ears from the darkness that they've been living in, and you persecute them, you could shed somebody's innocent blood if they were a weak believer or a weak Christian, but I'm not that one, thank God. I'm not prideful. It's all by God's word. It's all by God's doing. You can't kill me, but you kill people out there who are still not strong in the word of God, but trying to go forth doing what God called them to do, but because you think you know them from 25 years ago, you sit there and spread that lie around, which God just says he hates liars, okay? And you try to get everybody not to like the one person that God may be using in your tribe to set you free. How about that? Excuse me. Get a little sip of water here. So, we got three things so far. Just a small recap. We got a proud look. We got a lion tongue. And we got hands that shed innocent blood, y'all. Look at this. These are the things God hates. These aren't the things I hate. I'm not telling you this. This is what the word is saying. But every day, this is what you do. You take shots at people on Facebook. You insult people you don't even know. Now, if that ain't disrespectful and just out of control, I don't know what is. Like, haven't you been raised better than that? No, okay, you just get grown and you now you just lawless and you just out here doing what you want to do. This is for the people, Salafa, that do this stuff, okay? I know, because I know there's a lot of us out here that God truly loves. And it's because we are humble. We walk in humility. But see, there's a difference between humility and humiliation. And a lot of you like to humiliate people. God wants us to walk in humility to Him, saying, Lord, there's nothing I got that I didn't get from You. You are the creator of me and everything in my life. But some of you like us to be humiliated. Although it comes from the same root word, I find it all humorous. It comes from the same root word too. Probably is the root word. You can't humiliate somebody that's humble to God. You just can't do it. I'm going to wait you to Facebook is there. And she is so patient. Miss Salafa, God bless you. So patient. The internet keep going out on Facebook. And Miss Salafa is so patient with just being there. God bless her, you guys, for the rest of today. I mean, and the rest of the year. She's really patient. But those you can't. Those are three things right there. Proud tongue, proud look, lion tongue, hands that shed innocent blood. And, you know, people are, we got seven to go, hang in there. People are really putting Christianity out there the way they want it to. If you're going to hate anything, be like God and hate these things right here. That's why I come so hard, because I hate liars. I hate people shedding innocent blood, people's dreams, killing their life too short, spiritually killing them, anything keeping somebody from knowing the truth in Yahweh, I hate that. That's why I go so hard on my page and keep my page open for Yahweh to say what He want to say. Because some of y'all ain't there yet. And just like when I was in the street doing wrong, if I didn't listen to God and the people that He was putting in my life, I wouldn't be here talking to you today. I'd still be out there in the street doing what you're doing. That's with a proud look, saying I got everything on my own, with a lying tongue, deceiving people. I had one friend, she used to go buy her own damn jewelry and say the man she was dating gave her an engagement ring. That's some damn lying stuff if I ain't never seen it. Okay? But come on. And then you got people out here quick to shed innocent blood, killing people for no reason, killing people because of what they said, killing people because of what tribe, what city, what nation, what language they speak, killing people because they want to be a believer in Yahweh, killing people because they don't want to go to hell, killing people because they want to change. And not only that, I'll take it one step further. Killing people's dreams, telling them they'll never be nothing. Oh, God ain't called you. You ain't the chosen one. You just hearing your own self, your itchy ears. That is in the Bible, because the slave masters who gave the slaves this book gave them this doctrine of Christianity to oppress you, so that when people like me and other people said, no, they did y'all wrong. Christianity is not adding up to what it really supposed to be. God will always add up. Yahweh will always add up. Christ will always add up. Yeshua will, the Holy Spirit. But this Jesus and this Christian church way of living is not adding up. They'll tell you, oh, you got itchy ears. Oh, people coming speaking this false doctrine and all that nonsense. Let me tell you something. That's not the truth. It's people out here like you and I who are woke to this, who are spiritually woke to what's really the Bible is going on and what it's really about, and we get into the bottom of it. Okay, so just bear with me. Facebook is coming back in, YouTube. Hold on 1 second, guys. You gotta love it, though, man. There's people out here that know the truth and will keep telling you is for somebody else. But it's your truth. Thank you, Salafa. Okay, we're going on to number 4. A heart that devises wicked imaginations. Come on, man. You got people out here devising wickedness, imaginations against people, creating stuff, starting stuff, getting with their little cliques, their little friends, people on the job, devising stuff against you to cause you to fall, to cause you to stumble. That's not Christianly. God don't like that, because he got some people in this world trying to walk upright like Abraham, Eleazar, Moses. All these people walk upright before God. Was they perfect? No, but they just had a willing heart to listen and to do what God said do. That's what set them apart. Because they was in the world just like you and I, with everybody else doing everything they doing, but God finds favor with people like he did Noah. Noah was a drunk. His sons had to go cover up his nakedness. And white people told the black people the reason why our skin is black, because God cursed us that Noah's son Ham saw him naked. I tell you the stories they tell you in this Bible around Christianity to make you believe you black because of a curse. It's not true. Noah was the biggest drunk in the world, but God found favor in Noah. So people tell you drink and drink. I don't care about what you're drinking and what you're drinking on. I want you, the Bible says they drank from the same spirit and was drunken. Drink from that spirit. That's the spirit I want you to drink from. Okay? We've been taught. And then, you know, you get all these, the Bible call it wives' fables. That's been put in here and inserted in here just to keep you confused. Hold on, YouTube. Just 1 second. So, Salafa, thank you. So, people have put things on you to make you believe, but if we take the time to read the Bible, you'll get more clarity, more insight. You will be able to say, oh, this is what God means. Oh, this is what man might have meant, or this doesn't sound too godly. You can go to God and say, God, through the Holy Spirit, give me wisdom and revelation to understand what this means. And God will break it down to you. So, we got 4 things so far. We got a proud look, a lying tongue, hands that shed innocent blood, and a heart that devises wicked imaginations in Genesis 6 and 8. 6 and 6 or 5. 5 and 6 says, for man's heart is continually evil, and God hates that. God says it all. He almost wanted to repent in Genesis 7 that he created man, but instead he found favor with Noah, put them on the ark, caused the flood, and started this thing all over again with us. Thank God for that, right? And we run around here with the little minute things, and we don't even realize that there's things out there that is worth greater thankfulness. All right, YouTube, 1 second. Hold on, YouTube. Hold on, 1 second. Thank you, Facebook, for coming back. So, the next thing, after you realize that God hates a divisive heart, that a heart that divisive wicked imaginations, Once that heart devises the wicked imagination, what does it want to do? God knows right here, feet that be swift into running to mischief. You got a lot of people out here quick to run into mischief. You don't even know what the mischief or the problem is, but because you friends with so-and-so, you want to jump on a bandwagon and put your 2 cents in it or have your opinion about somebody for no reason. Or you want to go just start a lie over here, start a lie over there, steal over here, steal over there, start trouble over here, start trouble over there. Your feet is quick. The Bible says feet that be swift and run into mischief. You got people out here that fit all five of these so far. Proud look, lying tongue, hands that shed innocent blood, a heart that devises wicked imagination, feet that be swift and run into mischief. And you the people be the first one to say, ooh, I'm blessed. But you don't realize how much God hates you because of this. Now remember, he says 6 of these things doth the Lord hate. Yea, 7 are an abomination. Let's go there. Because that's only 5. Thank you, YouTube. We gonna get through this. We almost done. I didn't mean for it to go this long. I gotta figure out a way to get Facebook from not having, it says due to poor signal or something. That's what it's saying, Salafa. So we're almost done. We got through a proud look, lying tongue, hands that shed innocent blood, a heart that devises wicked imagination, feet that be swift and run into mischief, a false witness that speaks lies. Not only does he hate a lying tongue, he hates a false witness that speaks lies against other people. And that's what so many people do today on Facebook, off Facebook. If your stuff ain't flowing right, if you ain't getting comments or likes, if ain't nobody showing you no love, here you go on the phone messaging people. That's why I don't do messenger. Say what you gotta say on my page, and we can have that dialect publicly. So it won't be no he say, she say, and all this other stuff. Because when you get in somebody's inbox, that's when you start bearing false witness. That's when you start lying. That's when you start deceiving wicked hearts and imaginations. And that's when your feet start being swift to run to do mischief. That's when you get a proud look and all. I'm not with all that, okay? I don't got time for all that. I'm a grown woman. I love talking, but we ain't going to talk about anything. We're going to talk about some truth that will set people free. Okay? And not what you talk. Because when you bear false witness against somebody, hang in there, YouTube. Thank you, Facebook. Thank you, Salafa. So, when you start bearing false witness against people, lying on people, trying to go back, I'm 50 years old, and if the only dirt you can find on me is when I was 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, I went to prison. I rededicated my life to Christ, and what? I'm not perfect. What can you find on? What am I doing wrong? Everybody make poor choices financially. Here, you pay for stuff. You marry the wrong person. You make up for that. God is with you. We all running around here talking about bless, bless, bless. But these things God hate. And I said to myself, I was not going to be a part of this when I learned this verse years and years and years and years and years ago. If God hates something, why you want to do this? Why you want to lie on somebody? Why you want to lie? Why you want to have a proud look? Why you want to have a heart devising a wicked imagination? Why you want to have a feet swift to go be into mischief? Proverbs 24:16 says, the righteous shall fall 6-7 times and rise again, but the wicked fall into mischief. I've never fell into mischief. I made some mischievous choices in the past. But God never left me there. And that's what you have to understand. almost there, almost there, almost done. Almost done, YouTube. Thank you. Almost done. So, thank you so much, Facebook. So, yeah. So, it's like, the proud look.